5th of April 2018. This is a 10-year-old female cat.
Split, yeah. Okay, this cat has been split when she was, how old was she when was split? Quite long, right?
In 2008.
Yeah, it was about 10 years ago. So it was, there was no problem with feet. Now the complaint is this cat has feet, seizures, they call it. Now, the causes of this having feet is very hard to tell in cats and dogs. Sometimes we know, sometimes we don't know. Many of the causes are actually unknown. Now, of course, the usual causes are diabetes due to the low blood sugar, and with low blood sugar, they go into fits and coma, and with saliva coming out from the mouth, there is one cause. Diabetes is one cause. Then the other cause, of course, brain infection or brain damage or brain tumor is one cause. Then other than that, liver and kidney disease, as well as some cats, they have this sudden stress, change of environment, a change of food. But this is only one time fit, but this one has been having fits recurring. We call it a recurring because it comes back again. Now, what happened was it in November? November 2016, which is about 1 year ago. More than that. Now is 2018, March. So about how many months? About 12 plus 14 months ago, right? 14 months ago, this cat came in with fits, and we took the blood, and the blood shows that the glucose was actually high, but because it's only one blood test, so I can't say whether this cat had low glucose or not. Because sometimes they come in, they have recovered. Okay, so urine was normal, the glucose. So that was about 14 months ago, right? Then after IV drip, the cat was discharged after 3 days, and the owner was asked to give Phenobarb. Phenobarb 30 milligram is to control the fits. And she has been doing it quite hardworking in the sense that she gives it every day. 1/4 of 30 milligrams Phenobarb, a tablet, 2 times a day, right? And she has been giving it quite consistently, so there was no fit at all in this cat. So around 6 months, right, she gave 6 months, once, 2 times a day, and the cat was okay. The only thing was the appetite has increased, and she has put on weight at the time. But that is one advantage of having this, the side effect of this Phenobarb tablets, for anti-fits tablets. Then after that, she decided to reduce to 1/4 tablet at night, right? For how long? For 1 month.
Yeah.
For 1 month. We should recently, because 1 month.
No, last year.
Also last year.
Yeah. After that, I stopped totally.
So after that, she stopped and completely. For how long? From completely.
June.
From June, from June until now is
March. Eight, ten, is it?
Yeah. Anyway, from June 2017 to now is March 2018. About 10 months, right?
No. April.
April. Okay. So how many months is that?
Nine.
So about 9 months, this cat is not given any anti-fits medication, and she was okay, perfectly okay, right? And as active as ever, and appetite didn't increase, right? Because no more tablets already.
Normal.
So appetite is normal, everything is normal. Drinking not excessively, urine not excessively, and stools okay.
Yeah.
Now there's another cat in the house. This is a male cat, same age.
Male, yeah, same age.
Sibling.
Sibling, yeah.
Do they share the same litter box?
Yeah.
They share the same litter box?
Yeah.
So one of the reasons could be, of course, sharing the same litter box. Some cats don't like it, but this one has been used to it, right?
Yeah.
So now this cat came back because she had fits again. What time? 10 p.m. Midnight.
Midnight, yeah.
Midnight.
Wednesday, I think.
Tuesday, two days ago. And then, so she came for the tablets again, the medication, anti-fits, Philomath, 30 milligrams. So she gave 1 quarter tablet yesterday, 10 p.m. And after that, today, this morning, this cat started to scream. That was 8 a.m., right?
6 a.m. Yeah.
This cat started to scream and saliva comes out.
Yeah, stood like that.
Ah.
Like she like sitting, then screaming, then
mm-hmm.
got saliva. Never move.
What, any legs stiff?
No. Like she, side. No. This time, no. She no. Like not moving. Then after that, she like very panic.
Mm. So she had salivation
and
part of it. Now, the thing is, this cat actually doesn't like people to open her mouth.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Mm. How you manage to give the tablet?
When eating right, I put inside the food. Then put inside the
There's
mouth.
A strong bad breath.
Yeah.
There's a strong smell of bad breath. So this could be a smell of kidney or so, or gastric, but I do check.
Last time you said like got gastro or what?
That's not good.
The first
but
time,
I have a quick check. There's the enlarged lymph nodes. So this shows that there's some infection of the mouth. Normally they don't get enlarged lymph nodes. Is there any coughing or anything?
Sometimes.
She eats the dry food, right? Commercial one, right?
Yeah.
The male cat also, the sibling?
Same.
Okay, so there is enlarged submandibular lymph nodes, which is probably due to the infection in the mouth. Okay. So there's one finding. Now let me just check the other side, any enlargement of the lymph nodes. A quick check, prescapula. Cervical lymph nodes, they're okay. Armpit. Check the axillary. A quick one. Nope, nothing enlarged. Then goes down to the propitea. Propitea lymph nodes is here. Let's check whether it's enlarged. Now this seems to be a lump here. Seems to be enlarged a little bit. Check this side. No, don't think so. Don't have. No enlargement.
Normal.
Normal.
Is it fat?
Yeah, have a quick check on the heart and lungs and the abdomen. Have a quick check. Some pain in the chest.
Is it?
I'm crying. On the right hand side. No sounds, so okay. Heart and lungs are normal. I'm gonna check this abdomen. Patient. Check the kidneys. Any swelling or any pain? Just let go first. Does see any reaction? Let's see. Some pain a bit. There is some pain in the kidney area. Okay. Never having pass motion, right? A lot of stools. No pass motion. Yeah, a lot of stools. That is okay. Can't feel anything. Turn upside down, come. Have a quick check below. Now there's some leaking here.
Yeah, she like to leaking that
side. No, this is not normal.
Since last time.
From young?
Since after the sterilized.
Oh, after sterilization,
Yeah.
It's probably due to lack of female hormones.
Mm-hmm.
So, supplement will do. Okay. Turn. Let me check out inner side. Sometimes feet also can cause.
Cause what?
No, sometimes pain also can cause feet.
Oh, okay.
Pain.
Pain, yeah, that's why I suspect also.
Check here in a second. there's any oil or not. Okay, okay, nothing.
Okay,
okay, so we'll take a blood test.
Okay.
And we'll check the blood for any infection like total white cell count increase, then liver and kidney disorder. And of course there's infection in the mouth, there's the bad breath, which I'm surprised because the teeth looks not so bad. Has the cat been done dental scaling last time long
last
ago,
time,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah, then after they didn't do anymore, right? So we have to check the mouth. And other than that, the quality of the food is important. So
the
commercial one, the dry food. Yes. Let me see what is the quality. Maybe it's not suitable for this cat. Later you bring the bag down.
Okay. Then, just the food, is it?
The bag, there's a...
The brand. I don't have the brand.
Take photo of it.
I throw it. Maybe I can get from the pet store.
Sure. So, it's only that food, you don't need other food, right?
And wet food.
And wet food, same brand, right?
No. What is that? The normal one? The normal brand is...
Whiskey.
No, the other one. Got a lot of flavor, and
I don't know, but the dry food is first choice, right?
Yeah.
First choice for easy digestion.
Yeah, correct.
Okay, so it's hard to tell whether the food can cause fits or not. But the quality, if it's good, then it should prevent fits. So we're gonna check this. The diet. The cat is not fat. It's not fat.
Not fat yet.
No. So the temperature is okay. It didn't. Let me see the temperature. It's okay, normal 38.5. The weight is about 4 kg. So we will do the test and then we will drip. And we will check and see.
Stay for how long?
2 days or so.
Okay.